Let's talk a little bit more about how DataLink is going to recalculate some of these values. We need to first, though, discuss some fundamentals in Excel. Here's a function. It's the equals now function. This is a standard function in Excel, and it's known as a volatile function. That means anytime a recalculation is forced on the spreadsheet, then that's going to update. Now, the recalculation can be either if the user presses F9 or if auto recalculation is turned on and somebody just edits a field. Now, this DataLink function here, it's called PyArcVal. It uses as one of its arguments that that equals now cell, that cell that contains the volatile function from Excel. So it follows that if you make any kind of a change that will force this to recalculate, that will force this to recalculate as well. Now, in addition to that fundamental rule, you know, that makes a lot of sense. That's any function would do that. We also have functions like curVal. curVal is itself a volatile function. So anything that forces the Excel spreadsheet to change is going to force this to update in real time. So let's take a look at what happens when I edit this spreadsheet. Watch for two things. Watch for this value to change, and let's see if this value changes. By the way, this value will only show a change if there is a brand new snapshot value for this tag right here. So we may or may not see a change there. I'm going to go ahead and type in, let's just type the word test. Now that forced some interesting things to happen. That edit forced this to change, which in turn forced this to change. That edit also forced a recalculation of the spreadsheet, which resulted in PyCurVal getting a new value. So in summary then, the first rule of thumb is any type of a recalculation is going to force these volatile functions like PyCurVal, that's a volatile function, to recalculate. And also any of these functions like this equal now or equal today or some such like that. And if that recalculates, it may force other things that are built on that to recalculate. So let me just demonstrate. I'm going to press F9 over and over again. What we should see is this may recalculate, but this is definitely going to recalculate. See, as we keep recalculating, we're seeing this value update. Now, there is no new snapshot value. This PyArcVal is actually looking at the value at the current time. So in effect, it's reporting the snapshot value. Interesting thing, though. Oh, there we go. We got a new snapshot value. Now, this updates, but the timestamps are not necessarily going to be in sync. This is a timestamp that's referring to the current value that we're valuing or we're bringing in here. This is just bringing in whatever the last snapshot timestamp is. Now, that brings us to this function right here. This is the PySampDat function. Okay. With the PySampDat, let me show this to you. What we're doing is we're looking at sample data for, well, for the between this period of time at 1 minute intervals for this tag, CDT158. If we were to double click, we can see those are the dependencies there. You'll notice that this has not updated since we started discussing this. This has just sat there without having done anything. So there's two things that can change this. First of all, if you were to change any of the inputs, for example, if I were just to simply go in here and press return, that will in turn, I'm not going to press return yet, let me just press escape. When I press return, since this is dependent or uses that as an argument, that will force this to update. I'll demonstrate now. I can choose any one of these arguments. I'll press return now. As you can see, that forces this to update. Now, that did not update when I pressed F9 simply because these are not volatile fields. If I had, for example, used equals now, then this would have updated. So in summary then, with regard to functions like PySampDat that in this case are making reference to no volatile functions, then the only thing that's going to make these update is if I edit one of its components like that. Yeah, that's going to force this to update. Anything else, like if I press F9, like I'm doing right now to update this, that will not force an update. And also if I start typing in here, that's not going to force an update either. Now there's one other way we can get an update to this, and that's the special secret handshake we've kind of configured for doing what we call a full calculate. If you do a Ctrl+Shift+Alt+F9, that in fact forces the update. As you can see, Ctrl+Shift+Alt+F9. Each time I do that, that forces a recalculate of not only the volatile functions like this, but also the non-volatile functions, or the functions that are referencing non-volatile cells. There we go. Now let's wrap up this discussion by addressing this update option. If you recall, within settings, we had an option to control what is actually triggered when automatic update is turned on, when you click on this update button. Now I have it set to calculate right now, and it's going to default to, it's actually going to default to 5 seconds, because when you set this to zero, it means it's going to be the lesser of either, or excuse me, it's either going to be, it's going to be 5 seconds or twice the time it takes to recalculate the entire spreadsheet, whichever is greater, I should say, not the lesser. So in this case, zero is going to end up being equal to 5 seconds. That's the minimum that we can recalculate with. Or if I explicitly set this to 10 seconds, we could go with 10 seconds, but 5 seconds is the minimum. When I turn this on, watch what happens down here, and watch what happens to this function right here. This is going to update, or start updating, there we go, and it's going to update every 5 seconds. So every 5 seconds, we should get a new value there. There we go. As we can see, the interval is 5 seconds. Now, this interval of 5 seconds is doing a, what is it doing? It's doing a calculate, a regular F9. That's because I didn't choose to have it do a full calculate. Can you guess what would happen if I had set that as a full calculate? If I'd set it as a full calculate, then when I turn on this update button, we would do a full calculate, and all of these things would calculate, even the non-volatiles. So let's demonstrate that. I'll go into settings. I will change this so that we will, instead of doing a mere calculate, we'll do a full calculate. That special handshake, the Ctrl+Alt+Shift+F9. So that now, this now controls the behavior of the update. So when I do an update now, as you can see, even those things that are normally non-volatile will now do a full update.